Durag Wisdom here, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Earth Day Y2K 20.04.08. I think it's been all like 3 weeks or so since we've been with this lockdown. Just remember this, fake Senate impeachment trial, no vindication, no adjudication, and no exoneration. Repeat, music in the background. Appropriately enough, The Perfect Storm by the late, great James Horner. And this particular piece is dedicated to Flick C and other Trumpists I'd like to save. They need an explanation, a further review why I hate Trump so much. We don't want to forget that we have a presidential election coming up in a little more than 205 days. We don't want to have this CV-19 disease interfering with our constitutional right to vote, do we? We are already afflicted with a Trump-vid-45 virus whose possible cure comes on election day, unless half of us don't vote again. Election day, of course, should be a national holiday. More about that another time. No doubt about it, because even Trump's himself said if we allow for, say, a national mail-in ballot kind of thing, his Trumpists would lose. And that's sad, because there are some decent conservatives out there who really represent the Republican Party as it should be, because we always need an opposition in this two-party system we have. So imagine what a national election day would bring if we all had the day off. Trump and his totalitarian oligarchs want to make voting as difficult as possible. Note the pictures. The horrific pictures of long lines of people wearing protective masks while waiting to vote in Wisconsin. That is a Trumpist coup of that state, with the help of the Republicans in the legislature in Wisconsin, the help of the Trumpist Supreme Court, to hurt people's voting, to be able to vote, to make voting as unpleasant as possible. From day one of Ted Trump's administration, there has been nothing but the violation of our constitutional rule of law. Just remember what we allowed to climb into our presidency. And just remember who also helped. A creep named Putin. Remember that the CV-19 has no political or religious point of view. It does not respect borders. CV-19 may not even be a living being as we know it. Some call a virus simply a replicator, but it can be eradicated. On the other hand, to eradicate this other virus, the one that we have in our presidency, we need to exercise other forms of treatment with an eventual vaccine against, among other things, ignorance. But at least we can begin with the power of the vote. Never forget the Wisconsin primary being conducted during a pandemic, with citizens being forced to stand in long lines in cold and dangerous conditions. Remember that Trump and his little Trumpists do not want you to be able to vote, or they at least want to make voting as difficult as possible. Kafkaesque comes to mind. More about that. Remember Puerto Rico? I'll never forget Puerto Rico and the Trump response to Hurricane Maria. He murdered 3,000 people, as far as I'm concerned. 3,000 American citizens dead in Puerto Rico because Trump's a maggot racist creep. All he had for them was paper towels. More important than people, like numbers are more important than people. Remember too, the Pennywise, the traitor Trump, despises anything that is not as white as he is. If it were up to him, our planet would be drenched in so much white that the White House would be of color. Putin is now slobbering, awaiting the news that millions are dead in the USA. Putin put the right fiend in charge. First, Puerto Rico, and now the mainland USA. And Putin gave Trump permission to start destroying the blue states first, the states that don't like him, deservedly so. If I am still alive on November election day, I intend to vote for the life of our unique and free country. I will always remember and never forgive what this thug, sociopath, racist, traitor, birther creep Trump has done to us and to our country. All who have died under his watch are as blood on his entire cursed, bloated body. Now comes the review, maybe even a rehash, but I want all to know, especially those Trumpists out there I want to save, that I never forget and never forgive the maniac in charge. I understand that hatred is bad and love is good. God has blessed Nancy Pelosi for saying that she doesn't hate Trump. On the other hand, it would be dishonest to me personally if I did not acknowledge my bottomless hatred for the tumor we allowed to grow in our White House. I wish only the worst for Pennywise, the Trump Cheeto, because if I honestly hate someone, I can't be clearer than that. It is personal for me. So by the numbers, why I despise Pennywise, the Trump, the evil clown. 1. I will never forget the bullies that I've had to deal with when I was growing up. My formative years, or my deformative years. And throughout my life, later life, in the form of the boss. I have a kind of PTSD from this bully shit, excuse my French. Trump reminds me of all the bullies I've ever seen in my life, and I will never recognize him for anything higher than a microbe. 2. Pennywise Trump the Clown refused to accept the presidency of the first person of color, Barack Obama. The racist Trump attempted to advance a conspiracy theory that Obama was not a natural-born American. 3. Traitor racist Trump follows the philosophy of Hitler's Nazi propaganda minister, Joseph Goebbels, who said, "Tell a lie often enough and it will become the truth." Check out what he does. And he learned this, many hands Trump learned this from the lips of Roy Cohn, ironically a member of my Jewish tribe. 4. Nazi Trump is a white supremacist. He said that there were good Nazis on the other side. He was Heil Hitlered in, or Heil Trumped in, by the white supremacists. And he was so happy and so clear about his feelings about the good Nazis on the other side in the wake of the tragedy in Charlottesville, Virginia. 5. Slimeball traitor Trump separated children from their parents at our southern border. He locked children, even infants, up in cages. Turd Trump has single-handedly traumatized, maybe even ruined, part of a whole generation of children alive today. Imagine all the damaged human beings this fecal ball, Trump, has helped to create. 6. Traitor Trump is going to ensure that we have kangaroo courts of right-wing religious extremists, injustices from the lowest of the federal courts to the Supreme Court. And these injustices have lifetime terms. Imagine the future generations are going to be ruined by a scumbag fake conservative interpretation of economic, social, and religious ideologies. There are real conservative interpretations, but this is all fake stuff coming out of the Trump sewer. I understand that human beings are best when they are making each other as miserable as possible. Traitor Trump knows that fact as much as I do and uses it. I believe that the majority of us want to live our lives without being abused by extremists, religious or otherwise, while at the same time respecting everyone's right to free expression. Trump believes that religious fundamentalists are instrumental in helping him to retain power. The only faith he has is his ability to con the feces out of the clueless. And those clueless religious extremists could care less, since whether Trump is a holy man or not, he is giving them everything that they want. I personally take a dim view of a future where the children of the day have to live under the rule of religious extremist totalitarians like the Handmaid's Tale, thanks to a maggot named Trump. A maggot president shat into this world by another rich, racist real estate developer. 7. Trump does not respect our planet, its life, and its natural wonders. 8. Trump wants to destroy a woman's right to choose. He doesn't respect women in general. 9. Traitor Trump violates the rights of LGBTQ people. 10. Traitor Trump is a liar, a cheat, a thug, a dangerous sociopath who knows how to use Orwellian techniques, whether he knows it or not. He will never fool me. 11. Trump and his party want to violate our right to vote, make it as difficult, as Kafkaesque as possible. 12. Traitor Trump disrespects our journalists and our free press. He doesn't care if they die. Jamal Khashoggi ring a bell to you? 13. Pennywise the Trump is going to use the COVID-19 to finish what Putin wanted to start. Trump is even going so low as to recommend an experimental treatment for the disease, because Trump believes in numbers, those in favor of him. My hope now is that if the monster manages to slither his way back in, that we managed at least to not only augment the Democratic majority in the House, but that we also gave the majority to the Democrats in the Senate as well. I'm hoping. I'm saying past tense. At least then, I won't have to worry about Ruth Bader Ginsburg dying during a second Trump term, because he won't be able to appoint anyone to replace her. Imagine that creep with an entire legislative branch against him, because we have two against us now, the judicial and his. Even so, no matter what, a second term of the MAGA Trump is unacceptable. I despise him, no matter how you say it.